Welcome to the Control-M Calendars video. In this video, you will learn about three types of calendars: regular, periodic, and rule-based calendars, and we'll learn how to create them. To create or manage calendars, from the Tools domain, click Calendars. First, we'll talk about a regular calendar. Let's click New, and then select Regular. You can use a regular calendar to schedule jobs or folders based on the days of the month or days of the week. For example, you can create a calendar for weekdays or weekend days. We'll create a calendar for weekdays. First, we'll give the calendar a name. Make sure you enter the name correctly, as you cannot edit the name at a later time. Then select the relevant server. Note that All applies to both distributed and mainframe servers. A quick way to select all weekdays is to click Recurrence. In the Weekdays area, select the checkbox for All Days, and then remove Saturday and Sunday. You can apply this to the current year or multiple years. Note that you can use a regular calendar and select additional scheduling properties to further control the scheduling of a job. A regular calendar is also helpful if you have many specific dates that you want to schedule. For example, if you want to run a job every 5 days in a month, you create the calendar using the same method. Create a new calendar, enter the name, and select the Control-M server. Click Recurrence, and in the Month Days area, select the relevant days. Apply the month days to the relevant years. Now we can click OK to save the calendar. With all calendars, you see a preview of the calendar in the right pane. When you have finished creating a calendar, you need to check it in so that it's available when you schedule jobs. During check-in, the calendar is synchronized with the server. We'll check in the weekdays calendar too. Next, let's talk about periodic calendars. You can use a periodic calendar to schedule jobs that should run according to time periods other than months and days. For example, on a quarterly basis, every other week, or even every other day. Creating a periodic calendar is similar to creating a regular calendar. Let's click New and select Periodic. For periodic calendars, there's an additional field, Periods. Notice that the A period is selected by default, so you can begin selecting the days or dates for the first period in the calendar. For a quarterly calendar, you would select January, February, and March. Notice that all the dates now have an A in front of them. For the next period, click B and then select the next 3 months, and so forth. If you have made a mistake, you can start over by clicking Clear Year. To create a periodic calendar for every other week, you would use the same method. Note that you can go back to a period and make changes or additions to the period. If you want to select a date that should apply to all periods, click More to reveal all the periods, click the asterisk, and then select the date that you want. When you are finished, if you want to copy the calendar to another year, click Copy Year and select the years that you want. Click OK to save the calendar and then check in the calendar. Last, let's look at the rule-based calendar. Notice that in this dialog box, instead of seeing all the dates in one year, the options you see are the same ones that you see in the Scheduling tab of the Job Properties. Rule-based calendars can be used for numerous scheduling scenarios. For rule-based calendars, the schedule that you select is not related to a specific year, meaning that the job will run according to this calendar until you change the scheduling for the job. We'll create a calendar to run jobs on the last 3 days of each month. We'll give the calendar a name, and again make sure the correct Control-M server is selected. In the Schedule drop-down list, we'll choose Month Days. By default, Days of Month is selected. We'll click None to clear all the days, and then click the last 3 days. Let's click View Schedule to check our selection. You can see that the last 3 days in every month is selected, except for February, and in some months, only 2 days are selected. To make sure that the last 3 days are selected for all months, we will choose Days from End of Month instead, and then click -1, -2, and -3. Now we see that we get the result that we wanted. We'll click OK to add the calendar and check it in. Now you have learned about the three types of calendars you can create and use when scheduling jobs. Thank you for watching this video.